speak in English so that Eva can understand, everybody will understand, I think, because Eva is going to speak in English. I don't know if Telmo and Marco what they want to do, but anyway, Eva doesn't understand Italian, so. As Giulio was saying, this is the last conference of this short series about Voglia evoluzione, was the number, the name of the series. We had Giuseppe Fusco, Alessandro Milelli, and Fabio Fornara in November talking about Evo Divo. I don't know how many of you were there, it was very interesting. And then there was Dr. Walter Salzburger from Basilea and Dr. Marco Caccianiga from here, the University of Milan, in January about plasticity. So we are talking about these new concepts in evolutionary biology. It was interesting to see examples both from zoology and botany. So we tried to keep this double focus. Today, Professor Eva Jablonka is with us. Eva Jablonka is a theoretical biologist, most of all, working in Tel Aviv, Israel, and at the Kuhn Institute for the History, Philosophy of Science and Ideas. So, Eva Jablonka did some very good experimental and empirical work, but then she got interested in theoretical issues in evolutionary biology, and so today her name is known, is worldwide known, most of all associated to epigenetics. Her name comes out every time we talk about epigenetics, and not only on epigenetics, but on some position she has on the theoretical impact epigenetics should have and can have in on evolutionary theory. So her most famous book is Evolution in Four Dimensions, that gives also the name to the meeting today, written with Marion Lamb in 1995 and re-edited, I think, in 2005. We have a very good Italian translation of it, which is Evoluzione in Quattro Dimensioni from Utet. You can read it in Italian. And the book deals with mostly the various channels through which biological characters can be inherited and passed on through evolution. And her views raised in the past years, her views raised many reactions and many intriguing debates in evolutionary theory. One of the focuses of this theoretical ferment, for example, if I'm not wrong, is revolves around this, re-evaluation of Lamarckian inheritance, a form of Lamarckian inheritance, although this is a complex issue, maybe Jablonka will talk about it. And there is also some movements, some groups that see themselves as neo-Lamarckians, and there are conferences on this. But I think the most interesting is not dividing scientists in groups, like factions, battling with one with the other, so they are neo-Lamarckists versus Darwinists, but most of all, it's more interesting that everybody is working on a new, revised, and extended theory, evolutionary theory, that explains better and takes into account all the new biological discoveries we had in the last years. So one way of describing this revision, this ongoing revision, is the idea of an extended evolutionary synthesis, which I think will be the main topic of Eva's talk today. And Eva and Marion Lamb were among the Altenberg 16, I think. So they were in Vienna in 2008. With other biologists discussing this extension of the synthesis, and you can find, indeed, you can find their essay, the contributed essay in the book, in the proceedings of that meeting, which is Evolution, the Extended Synthesis, edited by Gerd Müller and Massimo Pigliucci, by MIT Press in 2010. You can The two discussants are two scholars, very important in Italian evolutionary biology. There is Tavo Pievani, a philosopher of biology, professor of philosophy of science at the University of Milano Bicocca. Tavo has written very much on the revision and the extension on, and worked very much on the extension of evolutionary theory, following the footprints, you can say, of one of his teachers, who were Stephen Jay Gould. And by the way, I want to remark that Stephen Jay Gould died 10 years ago, and Sunday will be the exact date. And indeed, both Marco and Tavo were last week were in Venice at the Gould Memorial Conference, so it was very interesting and fascinating. And Tavo sees evolutionary theory as a healthy research program, and he's applying one of his ideas is to apply some ideas from philosopher Lakatos, and he sees evolution as a research program. Maybe he can talk about this later. Anyway, a clear view of what evolutionary theory is for Tavo is very important in science communication and in public debates on science, in order not to create confusion about, you know, what evolutionary biology is. And in fact, this is a field that is constantly committed to very much communication of science in public debates. As many of you know from exhibitions and festivals and radio, TV programs and all the rest. Just mention his last popular book, which is La vita inaspettata, Unexpected Life, that deals with the importance of contingency in natural history. So, and then there is also Marco Ferraguti, who is an evolutionary biologist. He's professor of evolutionary biology here at the University of Milan. He has been president of the Italian Society for Evolutionary Biology. And he always says that he refuses to write anything about evolution, most of all because it is such a rich field and that many brilliant scholars have contributed to this field, so he never knows who to credit for the several ideas that there are in this field. And this is true, but it's also true that evolutionary biology needs, I think, people like Marco, who is curious and open and always attentive to the various theoretical and empirical novelties in all the fields of evolutionary biology, and someone that constantly goes beyond his own narrow field, which for Marco, I don't know actually the details, but is oligochaete worms and particular speciation and spermatozoans. And by the way, Marco recently broke the tradition of not writing about evolution by co-editing the very first Italian, all-Italian textbook on evolutionary biology, which is Evoluzione, Modelli e Processi by Pearson. I will now give floor to Eva with a very little excerpt from yesterday's dinner, because I think this speaks very well about her way of being a scientist and a theoretician and a philosopher too. At a certain point, Eva said that she is now working on the evolutionary origin of associative learning. We always call her to talk about epigenetics, but this is how it goes. So she is going on with others, other branches, other fields, very new and very interesting. And anyway, when Eva said this, I said, oh, I didn't know you were working on this topic. And she told me that she's been working on it for 8 years, but she is just now beginning to make sense of it because it's such a complex topic, and you have to learn so many things and put so different data, different theories, different fields to study so complex topic. And I said, oh, it seems a difficult topic. And Eva said, it is difficult, but it is tractable. So I think this is a mix of innovation and rigor in thinking, and I'm sure you will appreciate as well this in Eva's talk.